This is Kurt Heisinger, accounting professor at Sierra College and author of Managerial Accounting. This video describes the concept of resource constraints and how companies can make the best use of the resources that they have. So most companies have limited resources in areas such as labor hours, machine hours, facilities, and materials. In other words, companies don't have unlimited resources. They don't have unlimited access to a workforce or machine hours or huge facilities that they can use. Instead, they have limited resources because they don't have enough cash or capital to be able to just hire as many employees as they want. What we're focusing on here is the fact that these constraints can affect a company's ability to produce goods or to provide services. And we can use the contribution margin per unit of a constraint, and I'll describe what that means in a minute, as a measure in determining how constrained resources should be used. Here's an example. Kayaks for Fun produces two kayak models, the river model and the sea model. Based on the information that you see in this chart below, right down here, you can see that Kayaks for Fun prefers to sell more of the river model, just looking at these numbers, because the contribution margin per unit is $400 and is higher, therefore, than the C model, which has a contribution margin per unit of $150. However, this does not factor in any constraints that the company might have with their resources, for example, with labor hours or machine hours. In the next slide, we're going to take a look at what happens when we do have constrained resources, and we're going to look at another way to calculate this contribution margin. Here, we're going to learn how to calculate the contribution margin per unit of constraint. So, Kayaks for Fun has a total of 320 labor hours available each month. That's it. That's the maximum number of labor hours that can be worked within their production facility. The river model uses 4 labor hours to produce 1 unit, and the C model uses 1 labor hour to produce 1 unit. So clearly the C model doesn't use nearly as much in the way of labor hours for each unit built as the river model. And the company prefers, third bullet point here, the company prefers to maximize the contribution margin per labor hour, as you can see in the data below, by selling the C product. So if we calculate the contribution margin per labor hour for the river product, that's this calculation over here, we take the $400 in contribution margin per unit that you saw on the previous slide, that's this, and divide it by the number of labor hours it takes to build one river kayak, it's 4 hours, and that works out to a contribution margin per labor hour of $100. Do the same thing for the C model. The contribution margin per unit is $150, this calculation here, and it takes 1 labor hour to build the sea kayak. That means the contribution margin per labor hour is $150. What this tells us, if labor hours is our constraint, and it is in this example, this tells us that we would prefer to produce the sea kayak because it will yield a contribution margin per labor hour of $150 rather than the river kayak, which will yield a contribution margin per direct labor hour of $100. So again, this is another way to measure the contribution margin, but it's done per unit of constraint to evaluate how to make the best use of the constrained resource that we have.